This is not enough time to back in, and welcome back to Detective Conan and Kendaichi Case Files. Get off me, daughter. It's been a long... you go there, you're eating.
No!
Basta! Basta! It's been a long week, or a week and a half, since I last recorded. For the Conan and Kendaichi, so yeah. And a lot of things went to hell, so went loose, so forgive me. I don't remember what happens right now. And I will have to go back jogging my brain. Duck. What's with the duck?
Why the sleep is so long?
The next morning. Guten morning.
Why the sleep is so long?
Because... Anyway, today, I forgot to mention, today is December 4, and 4 o'clock in the afternoon, Hong Kong time standard, so yeah, again, a few days advance. No. Can you stop playing with my sleeve?
No, it does.
It's morning. Oh yeah, we're with Mochi.
Mochi?
I was thinking a lot, and I couldn't sleep at all. And Mochi went to sleep, isn't it? On the contrary, he... slept well. Good for you, Mochi. I feel great. Let's work hard today. He was complaining about not getting the case and went to bed. What do you mean not getting the case? The suitcase? After having slept one night, it's like nothing happened. Okay, Kendaichi. Let's continue the investigation. Good for you, Hyper. Let's solve this case in a flash and get back to Twilight Island. But you're already on Twilight Island! Yeah, yeah, let's, and then go, ooh. Yo, Mochi, let's have a talk. Let's do our best today, right, Kendaichi? Oh my god, my lemon tea, don't spill everywhere, please. Yes, I energy. I have a bad habit of opening canned drinks in front of a computer. It's getting on my nerves after I couldn't see things. So, where are we going? Oh yeah, we're going back to the Sly. Oh god. Good morning. Have a good rest? Had a good rest. Yeah, thanks to your hard work. The only one having a good rest was you, Uncle. I didn't sleep a wink. Well, see ya. I don't know your business, but good luck. Thanks, Grandma. Let's depart from the library soon. Yeah, that's right. There was a murder in the library. Thank God. Thanks for the introductions. Right, Uncle? I'm burping. Excuse me. La boirie. There's no one here. It seems that Hokkaido hasn't arrived yet. Oh, so we can make a detour. Come by if we're waiting. Well, surely. Okay, so we can take a tour. Let's try and see if we can take a tour first. Never mind. Can I get a tour? I think it'd be best if we waited for him. I don't want to be nagged again after all. But he's late, that bastard Hyoki. Maybe he forgot about us already. Maybe. Talk to you first. Uncle, what do you think about the Hyoki? I need a recap because I haven't remembered what I did last time. What I think of him is that he's a bastard. He will absolutely not escape unscathed. You got a revenge. I won't forget being confined in that storehouse.
Mother, what is this for?
It's for the charts. Go away.
Charts?
Yeah. About the case. Charts? Yeah. Today, this investigation is a game between wits. The more time we take, the
Judge?
More complicated the case will be.
Judge?
Yes! Oh, yeah. That's true. We can't properly preserve a crime scene in this environment. I'll settle this today for sure. Yeah, aren't you motivated? Thank God you finally came. I love that slyness. You're like Snape, goodness sakes. Every time, goddamn Snape, I keep looking. Woo! Jeez, yelling in the morning. You're more annoying than this heat. Well, I'm more annoying than you, if that's okay. He's here! Bio! Let's hurry and start the investigation. You're busy, right? How clever you, Mr. Grandson of Kintaichi Kosuke. Sharing his blood doesn't mean you're as proficient. Some kids choose to walk the opposite road of their parents. Let's see, what's that mean? Well, Yogi, you promised the crime scene was preserved, right? Yes, it's the same as yesterday. Nobody entered the office after you left. Hyoko-san, I'm just warning you about it. No matter how much you obstruct, I'll definitely expose the truth. Heh, talk comes cheap and easy. If you want, I'll show you. That I am not just all talk. I am face of stupidity. We're only losing time standing around here. You're the one who started! Should we get started with this? Neji, I have something to ask of you. Please don't ask something stupid. What is it, Uncle? That sudden formal tone. Exactly! Listen, no matter what it takes, solve this case. Solve this case. I'm with this irritating guy! I will make you like a cat. Yeah. Count on it. Leave it all to me. Because I'm the only one who's working hard. You're the only one just walking and standing. Being a cat. All the employees are gathered. Begin when you're ready. I'll stand by to observe your incompetence. Let's start with what we left off with the employees' names. Yeah, I didn't never get to ask their names. I'll ask the librarian. I would like to start with your names. I'm sorry, your name is? What's wrong? Just want to ask your name. Seems she doesn't want to speak. I don't condone coercion. What did you do? What did you bastards do? Wow! All of them don't want to speak! Are you listening? Wow, son of a bastard! She got so angry when I shot. She's not reacting at all. This guy is maybe... Probably planned this. He forbid the employees from speaking with us, no doubt. They don't want to give us information. But the found boys already finished the investigation. Yogi, that's playing dirty. You told them not to talk! Spare us the vain excuses. Their silence is their own will. I can't hear bear you accusing me of that. Damn, such obvious lies. That's really pissing me off. Shut up! Hey, Uncle, relax. Out the way, Kenaiji, I won't forgive him. Uncle, come down. This is another of Yoki's tricks. He's provoking you to stop the investigation. Invasion. Is your mouth the only part of you you wish any fight? Maybe it's just that you really are the world's worst inspector. God damn it! But to be lectured by a kid. Uncle. Fine, Kenaiji. I'll endure it. Project your anger at him by solving this case. You just... Can I handcuff you for a while? In the meantime, I must endure. Will he really calm down? Nope! But, there's no way I'll give up. So first, let's find proof we can link to the culprit. I'll check every inch of this library. Alright, Nanko. Investigation start. Telephone. Beautiful source. There's a number on this. It's 111. There's a phone on the counter. It's only for internal call. The numbers 111 are written on the paper stuck to it. The receptionist was using this to call the archive back then. Alright, so let's try it out for sure. The archive number is... What's this? Let me see. So, the archive number is... And then she'll just talk because she's annoyed. Damn! What is it? Ah! I'm already pissed off! I knew it! There's a list on the side of the phone if you just look! Eh? It's not there. I'm sure I put it here. Weird. You lost it? She lost her mind instead. It's not my fault. I'm sure I put it here. Ah! Sorry! Eee! She's staring right at me. It's not my fault, you bitch! Anyway, besides that, what she said is interesting. The phone number just was lost. Wow. Bunch of old newspapers. They should have thrown them away. The newspaper is... They're really old. Don't they all date back to at least 25 years ago? Has this library not been updated? Why these old newspapers be here? I can't even speak. Where the reception was yesterday, there was a phone using for internal calls at the desk. Okay. No, you did that already. Hmm. 111 lobby, 121 office. At the time of the crime, this receptionist was here with us. From that, it seemed difficult for her to leave the community of crime. So, where should I investigate now? Office, backyard, and we should look through all of them. Okay, I can roam around, that means. That's nice. I'll try the live outside yard. Library backyard. Last night I was right here. When I keep looking at this, I remember Phoenix Wright vibes. A girl just like Misa. I definitely saw her. Her real identity is that person. If it's like that. This piece of paper found in the incinerator. 1-1-1-2-1-1-1-2. Burn. So the one who looked like me said that through way. That person must be connected to the case, right? Okay, now we move off to another place. Oh guy, you're still dead. Ah, poor guy. Let's preserve as promised. Good thing for the investigation, but I feel sorry for leaving the victim here. Exactly! I feel sorry for the dead guy! You may find something we didn't notice yesterday. Telephone. 112. Seems to be only for internal calls. A paper with 112 written is also part of passed it on the top. Was fatal wound. We After the bullet from the gun pierced the victim, it also hit the fan that was here. Replaced with a new fan, so the bullet is no longer there. The bullet hole in the wall. The bullet shot by the culprit pierced the victim and the fan, and in the end, it got stuck in this wall. Bullet hole in the wall in the factory. Under the conditions, could it be that? What is it, Kendachi? You have something? The bullet went through the victim and the fan, and then to the wall. From those three, we can say where the bullet was from. Yes, from the telephone. Standing right here, shoot, boom. Boom? Ah, no, boom. Boom? Boom, boom, boom. There, bingo. I know, I look like an idiot. I'm trying to become Professor Snape, okay? Shush, I've been reading too much. Too much fan fiction. Too much DeviantArt. Too much Wattpad. If we find out, we'll learn something important. Okay, let's try. Map Inspector. Oh my god. Mama, what's it, the up close and personalness? It's so enduring. Oh wait, a moment. I need this. Thank you. Map about Map Inspector. If you touch the map reproduced on the bottom screen, the culprit icon will appear. By touching the culprit icon, you can slide. Move it to the place where the bullet was shot. Very easy. If you mistake the location, your larger coins will decrease, so be careful. Determine the place where the culprit was shot. Boom, boom, boom! Bingo! As I thought, it's here. The culprit shot from this position. But why here? No wait, the place is very close to the phone. And in other words, the culprit shot from a position by the phone. I see. I get it. Boom! The reason the culprit shot the victim from this position. The reason to shoot from this position. What do you mean? Uncle, I've uncovered it. The structure of the alibi trick fabricated by the culprit. But we haven't seen anything else yet. Well, now I don't understand anything anymore. Well, can we just go to the last place first? No, last place! We made it through the archive. So, where do we investigate? There's a phone on the wall at the end of the room. It seems to be only working internally, like the one in the lobby. A paper with the number 121 on it has been pasted on top. So, that's how it was. What are we talking about? I finally understand. If my deduction is correct, the culprit is probably that person. I see, that's how it was done. Ow! Managed to see through all of this. How the culprit should have been there committed a crime. I've solved this mystery. It was classed, my brain cannot cope with that. I've gathered all the proof necessary. Possible murder case that occurred in this library. Explanation behind this mystery is a pain in my ass right before my eyes. Okay, instead of the little gadget. Not again. Hello. Wait. Then you go! Why are you telling me? Hey, yeah! Why are you telling me where you're in the pool? No. Hold on. Okay, back. Had my key. My tea. My key. So... Okay, so... Let me get this straight. 1-to-1 lobby. Numbers was swap. That's what it meant. So, let's go back down and talk to my minion personal. I'm gonna kill that guy later. And then he's gonna shut me off, isn't it? The mystery is solved by me, yours truly. The fabulous. This. Mystery is solved. I shall palm you with my hand. I gathered everyone like you asked. Lady A, Lady B, Asshole I, Asshole B. Really? You said you solved the mystery. So you know who the culprit is. Look at that face of guilt. I know it. No way. The culprit can't be one of us. Alright, Kenaiji. Let's begin. Yeah? It's time to reveal the culprit who killed Ichinose Keiichi. Now I've grasped everything about this case. Not the goddamn map! Keiko. Go for it. Real identity of the victim. Extra details. No, I said extra details! Not again! What's X? I forgot all my buttons.
Mother, maybe next time I put the clay there.
X is S. Okay.
And then I
knows the real identity of the victim. This one. Ryuhei. Who works in the backyard at the time of the crime is Fato. Whose alibi was in the lobby at the time. Stench. Okay. Whose alibi was it that they're in the archive? I keep forgetting what's the name of the trio in Casper. The weapon used to murder the victim was the gun. Pistol. Alibi trick. Nothing used for the culprit. Sorry. Used for the culprit's alibi trick and then disposed of. This one. The one witnessed by Kendaichi disposing of it. Culprit in the murder case, who also works in the library. Correct again! The whole picture of the case. If you want to review the flowchart one more time, touch the info below. Nah, I'm good. I'm sorry. The killer of Ichinosekiichi would staged it as a suicide. Oh, my eyebrow is itchy. Why? I guess I know why, but it'll sound stupid. It was you! And the necklace. Eh? Me? No way. Suddenly saying, I'm the culprit. What the? I didn't do anything! You are the grandson of a famous detective. If you call someone out mistakenly, I won't let you off easily. Aoki-san, thanks for the warning, but I'm not mistaken. This is the absolute truth. To speak like that, you must have some faultless proof, correct? Yeah. If you accuse me of being the culprit, show me the proof. Oh, I will show you every proof I have in my pockets. My favorite?
This color.
Me? The purple.
Okay, for me is
pink. Pink, I know. But you have not finished your food!
I know.
I'll show you exactly what. And that, right now. What?
Here?
What?
Next time you put, I will help you.
Okay.
And then you help me this.
Okay. Ow, the faultless evidence.
I put this on now, you help me.
Later, I tell you, you eat first.
Ah!
Ouch. The faultless evidence. I'm sorry, I keep cutting. Let's go. Dun, dun, dun. Ooh, that one again. First, explain to us how you know the man in the office is not or dead. As far as I can tell, it isn't really just... Isn't it just really suicide? Of course it's not suicide. It's no suicide, sorry. This evidence found at the crime scene. This proves that. Okay. The evidence found at the crime scene proving murder is... gun, internal phone, bullet hole, broken fan. I replaced the broken fan with a new one. When I did, the suicide note on the table was blown away by the breeze. What about it? Is it even a problem? Oh, it's a very big problem. The fan was broken because the bullet from the gun pierced it. It's the same bullet that killed the victim. In other words, the fan was broken at the same time the victim died. Therefore, how could the victim have placed a suicide note on the table? The fan was working while he was alive. If he had put the note there, the wind would have blown it away. No one is even seeing the room! This definitely proves that the note was put on the table after the fan. Thus, it was also placed there after the victim had died. I see.
You didn't see before.
So, that's what happened.
You didn't.
Well, this proves the victim didn't commit suicide. You mean let me work?
I know.
Can you let me work? You do your eating. So. So we know the victim didn't commit suicide. But that doesn't prove I'm the culprit. Oh, I'll prove to that very now. Jeez, I know I was only answering the questions I asked. The real show begins now. I'm going to explain everything. That damn it, phone! Okay, back from phone call. I know how you killed Ichinose Keiichi. I can't pronounce the name. What are you saying? And I have an alibi. Your alibi is that you were in the archive room at the time, right? But that was all a lie. You faked your alibi using a certain trick. What? A trick? The trick that the culprit used to eat their alibi. The paper. This paper, do you remember it? You used this paper to build your alibi. You faked your alibi of being in the archive. What lies? There's someone attesting to my alibi, isn't there? Someone? Receptionist, you mean? Yes, I was talking with her on the phone on the archive. Wasn't she confirming it too? At least she was convinced you were in the archive. Eh? Stop these wild accusations. She was the one who called me when I was up there. If I had to be in the office to commit the murder, I couldn't have picked up the phone in the archive. So that's it. Let me answer that for you. The way you took the call to the archive was... took a call in the office. The phone you picked up isn't in the archive. It was in the office. Yeah, thunderstorm and lightning. I should see red nose. What are you saying? Didn't she say she called the archive just then? How could I have to answer the call in the archive from the office? You're still playing innocent. Yeah, she is. Let me expose your trick now then. Alright, first let's start by explaining this paper. This was taken from the incinerator outside last night. The burned part of this paper is the key. The burned portion of the paper was for the... This part once indicated the archive. How do you know that? Aren't you just guessing? Sorry, but I'm just not guessing. This paper is the internal call registry of this library. Yes, the paper the receptionist was making a fuss about losing. These numbers indicate the phone numbers from the rooms in here. The places with the phones are the lobby office and the archive. The only possibility for that burned portion is the archive. But that's not all. There are other oddities with this paper. What do you think they are? I don't know! I don't understand your nonsense. Then let me enlighten you, sweet cheeks. Note and spec. Oh yeah, wait, goodness. The strange thing about this phone registry is... Wait, I can't open the wallet. Don't break this one, huh? This is very old. That the office number written here is wrong. The real number for the office is... 1 1 I dread this pad. Thank you. Ding! Lightning! The correct number of office number is actually 112. No way! Ah, yeah, on the paper, the office and the phone number is 121. The number 121 is the original number for the archive. You get it now, right? The number for the archive and the office were swapped on this list. Thus, the receptionist wanted to call the archive, but got the office. Ugh! The receptionist started working here very recently. It is also easy to get confused by the numbers such as 112 and 121. It wouldn't be difficult to make her question her memory. Additionally, the numbers having been swapped isn't something that one normally would come to mind. Ah! Stop eyeing and ooing! You have made a fake phone number list and pasted it in front of the desk. You then answered a call intended for the archive from the office. That was also why you had to shoot from that position. The position next to that specific item in the office. The item where shot is placed. The item next to where shot is placed is the phone. Can you not make a mess here? Of course, it's the phone. You kill the victim while speaking on the phone with the receptionist. Stop! Yeah, you're in the office at the time of the crime. There, you waited for the call that you had arranged for the receptionist to make. As you pointed the gun at the victim, he was likely drugged and unconscious, hence why he didn't call out for help. Then you picked up the phone and acted as if you were in the archive. Good day. Before finally pulling the trigger. Bang! Well, this is the full story behind your alibi trick. No! Ah! After your crime, you disguised the death as suicide and fled to the restroom before we came to check on the gunshot. You then snuck back to the archive as if nothing happened. So, you still being defensive? You still have a defensive? If so, do you mind if we check your fingerprints against this paper? Even if we have to look everywhere for this island, we should be able to find the materials for checking them. So, what now? Still denying? Oh god. X-ray vision! Wow. Wow. Glasses, girl. Glasses! No, I'll stop. It's useless now. So, you admit to it? Yeah, I have no other choice. No way! I like this lady. Oh, I love her so much. You were the culprit? Why? Why did... I had a bad feeling. As soon as something unplanned happened. What is this? Unplanned pregnancy? Something unplanned. You coming in. I heard other people entering the library. It was just before the crime when I picked up the phone. But it was too late to abandon my plan. Everything went off the rails after that. It also wasn't planned for the fan to ring. Without thinking, I put the note there on the desk. I was surely too rushed. I can't believe it. This weak lady is a culprit. Don't say weak if she pulled it! But at least the case is solved. No, not yet. The case is still not solved. Eh? The case isn't over? What do you mean? We still haven't confirmed the culprit's real identity. This woman, hidden behind this veneer, is someone else. Her true self. Hey, Genaji, what do you mean? By her real identity? I'll explain. Everything right now. Her real identity is... one. Or this one. Oh no. I'm gonna get deducted, am I? Last night, we saw a girl very much like Misa in the library back here, right? That was actually the woman right in front of us. What? Are you sure? The thing that guided me to that conclusion was... Chili porn for favorite range thing. Only the culprit would know its significance and evidence. Something that could have been haunted. Could have haunted the culprit. She had to dispose of it by any means. The person we saw in the backyard who looked like Misa. She was about to dispose of that paper. For the culprit, it was damning evidence. No one could see it. But the murderer and the one destroying the evidence don't have to be the same person, could it? Could it have to be an accomplice? Yes, you're right. But there's something else. Something else that proves that it was her. It was... her necklace! It was her necklace. Her pendant. Try to remember. The girl who looked like Misa was wearing the necklace around her neck. Why you keep saying necklace and not pendant? The pendant looks the same as the one she's wearing right now. To confirm if my deduction is right, we can ask her to remove her glasses and tie her hair. And then all will be clear. Can we ask her to? Fine. I'll do as she asks. Untied her hair and removed her glasses. And from where she stood, a seemingly new woman was suddenly standing in front of us. I had to remember to breathe when I saw what was underneath. Underneath the clothes? Or underneath the disguise? So flawless! Kenaiji! Yeah, as I thought. I was right. Well, are you happy now? It's Misa. Exactly like Misa. And then I'll get cut off by the gas hole again! Who the hell are you? What do you mean, who? You look too much like one of my friends, Misa, who called me here. Toba Misa. What? When I said Toba Misa, the color drained from her face. As I thought, she has some connection to Misa. Answer me! Tell me your name! My name? No! Don't get cut! Mitsuru! What? Mama? Is this... Toba Misa's mother? Can't be. Her ages don't fit, do they? Misa was about my age. What's going on here? Are you saying it's just a coincidence? No! No, this is time travel! I swear! Hey! No way! Who are you talking about? That is not someone I know. Liar, you just made a raining colored face! As soon as I mentioned her name, exactly! That you know what I mean. I only react because you said the name Toba. I merely didn't expect someone having the same surname. She's lying! It can't be. It can't be coincidence. Damn it! I knew it!
Are you serious?
Yes. Huh? What? What do you mean why? Enough. Your free time with the culprit ends here. That's what I meant. No! I still have a free question. Her motive's still not... I thank you for having solved this little murder situation, but talking idly about this and that is a different story. I will isolate her in the coal factory I manage, right now. Why in a place you manage? There's no police presence on this island. There's no other good place to lock up a criminal. In other words, I'm graciously offering a place to lock her up. That's the end of it. You're saying we should be grateful. Give me one more minute! No, you cannot. We will take over and asking the questions. You get it. Your involvement ends here, as I say. What the? Say, have you forgotten the deal we made? If you disobey me, I'll have to forcefully evict you. By boat, of course. Damn! You bastard! Came to the library. They took away the girl named Toba Mitsuru. I ended up being unable to speak to her further. Well, freak you! Get her out of here. Oh, so muscular. Like watching TF2 again. Where's my towel? Nah, my towel! Ouch, my legs. The girl who introduced herself as Toba Mitsuru. Her facial expression had already faded away. I had no chance to ask what was on her mind. Dang it! Misa lookalike. Change to Toba Mitsuru. Darn it. Didn't you know she was a culprit from the start? If you ask me, you knew about the whole case. I can't shake that feeling. What a strange accusation. I was merely an onlooker for that little incident. The victim, Ichinose Keiichi. As a VIP, he was quite distant from the workers, you know? Was her crime motivated by that? I don't know the details, but isn't that probable? Well, now that the case is solved, it doesn't really matter. Darn it, little prick! Hiyoki-san, can you tell us more about the culprit? She said her name was Toba Mitsuru. Who the hell is she? Sorry, but I don't know either. It seems she's been working on this island for a long time. I didn't hire her. I'm hearing her name for the first time today. Toba Mitsuru. Is that such a rare name? What's the problem? You prick of a prick! Now that the case is solved, I want to ask you some questions. Questions. For me. With the culprit taken away, you're the only one to ask. The tragedy 25 years ago. Do you recall hearing that phrase? The tragedy 25 years ago. The case occurring now in the same tragedy as that tragedy. Someone like you who knows a lot about this island should know of that case, right? Not again. No, nothing. Yeah, I know, but you're not finished eating. I never heard... Later. Liar. Now that's out of the way, let's end this chit-chat. Wait, you still have... Nothing! Didn't I just say the chat term is over? I've had enough of the playground detective game. None of his answers helped at all. No matter what I ask, it's always the no idea. And let me warn you one last time. Don't poke your noses into other people's affairs again. We have all secrets we want to keep to ourselves. Remember that, boys. Damn him! We didn't learn a thing, a single thing in the end! I thought we'd learn more about the island by solving the case. The guy surely knows the island's history. If not, he wouldn't have a reason for hindering as much. Who the hell is he? What the hell is he plotting? I want to know that too. While I may have revealed the secret to the case, many mysteries still remain unsolved. The culprit with the name of Misa's mother, Toba Mitsuru. Who is she? What is the link between the tragedy and this repeated case? And where are we now? When where we are now? Another Twilight Island. The mysteries are still hidden behind a thick wall. Dang, it's so thick, I gotta save it for another episode. So, thank you so much for watching. I know if you're bored because I keep talking on and off, but there's no choice. I can't do anything else except click yes, no, click, 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 click. So, yeah. Thank you so much for watching. If you really liked it or if you don't like it, but you managed to have your patience to stay through the whole video and you want to watch some more, just simply wave your wand like a sorcerer and hit the like button, subscribe button to watch the next part. Boom! Bam! Because I gotta go read me some more Snape Hermione fanfictions and continue writing my story. So yeah. Until then!